The contribution of ICT to GDP is somewhat a bit difficult to evaluate. We know what the contribution of the telecommunications industry is. It stands at about 3.5% now. But then I've seen other studies that put the contribution of the ICT sector to about 8.5% when you take also the role of IT in enabling other industries such as banking, insurance, transport, hospitality. The cumulated contribution stands at about 80% and it's growing. ICT sector is a priority for the government of Rwanda since 2000. We've got a Vision 2020, and the overall goal of the vision is to take Rwanda into the middle income economic status by 2020 and migrating from being an economy essentially based on agriculture to an economy based on knowledge and services. So it's really part of our strategy, and the government has made significant investments in infrastructure, capacity building, and now we are supporting innovation. Well, there are three main areas where investments are required. One is accessibility of ICTs. We've done a big part of that in terms of putting the infrastructure in place, but there are still gaps in coverage and there are still opportunities to connect people. And I'm looking at both the supply side of the connectivity to the demand side. And the demand side is where we still need to do much in terms of increasing the penetration, especially of smart devices. So there are a big investment opportunity right there. Energy is a big challenge in the sector. So whoever invests in energy or actually somehow also invests in ICT. And Rwanda has reached about 16% access to electricity for households. We want to take that coverage to about 70% in the next 5 years. So we need a lot of investments in energy. The second area is capacity building. One of the things we need to do is really to increase both in numbers and quality of IT skills available in the market, because we're not only looking at Rwanda as such, we're also looking at the East African region and Africa broadly. So Rwanda is a place where, as many countries in Africa, a big youth population that needs those skills to really step into the 21st century kind of jobs. So we are inviting private training institutions. We are also inviting overseas universities to come and recruit students from Rwanda. We are really looking forward, you know, both for degrees and short courses and certificates. Right there in the human capacity building domain, there is a big investment opportunity. Now, the third area is services. We've got five key priority sectors. Healthcare, education, agriculture, government, and business, especially financial sector and small and medium enterprises and hospitality. So in those areas, people need applications, they need solutions. We are transitioning into the digital economy and we need solutions for automating those sectors, for marketing those sectors, for running those sectors. And it's a big investment opportunity, and it's an area where you can come and partner with our own local companies and train a lot of young Rwandans and transform them into a workforce that you can use not only in Rwanda, as I said before, but also in the region. The Rwandan government has put in place a number of incentives for investors to come and invest in the sectors that I highlighted as priority, especially the energy sector. But beyond just, you know, like fiscal incentive, what we've done is really to improve our environment of doing business. This year, the Doing Business Index ranks Rwanda the 32nd best environment to do business in the world and the second in Africa. So that index looks comprehensively at a number of factors: how you start your business, how government helps you in terms of buying land, And in case of failure, how do you fail aggressively? How do you repatriate your profits? But also, most importantly, we've got some fiscal incentives. You know, above a certain threshold, you are eligible to a tax holiday of a number of years, and so on and so forth. And you know, labor policies and so on. So all those are incentives that we believe are strong for people to come and invest in Rwanda. But what we are also presenting is a gateway to the African market. It's a gateway to the East African market. 135 million people. Africa as a whole is 1 billion market, people market. So we are ready to work with investors who are serious about taking Africa seriously. And then we go with them as they move and expand to the rest of Africa.